President Trump telling the Associated Press that blaming Saudi Arabia for the apparent murder of Washington Post contributor Jamal Khashoggi is another case of being, quote, guilty until proven innocent, end quote. I don't like that. President Trump then goes on to compare the situation to allegations against his Supreme Court justice. Quote, we just went through that with Justice Kavanaugh, and he was innocent all the way as far as I'm concerned, so we have to find out what happened. The president's stunning statement, as three sources tell CNN, that a high-ranking officer with the Saudi intelligence agency oversaw what the Saudis are now claiming was an interrogation of Khashoggi that went wrong. That officer, according to one source, has close ties to the inner circle of Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman, or MBS, as he's known. So the Saudis' cover story now hinges on whether you believe the king and Crown Prince MBS knew nothing about this. Here's President Trump earlier today.
It depends whether or not the king or the crown prince knew about it, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. Number one, what happened, but whether or not they knew about it. If they knew about it, that would be bad.
If they knew about it, let's look at the facts. On the day that Khashoggi vanished, Turkish officials say a 15-man team flew in from Saudi Arabia to Istanbul. Among the Saudi operatives was an intelligence officer and an autopsy specialist who, according to the New York Times, brought with him a bone saw, not the kind of instrument required even at a brutal interrogation. Now, those men are believed to have been inside the Saudi consulate when this surveillance video shows Khashoggi entering the building at 1:14 p.m. local time. Needless to say, Khashoggi never came out. Now, aviation data shows that those same 15 Saudis may have been on a flight back to their home country within a day. So, do you believe that a ruthless crown prince who rules with an iron fist would know nothing about this? The same crown prince who jailed hundreds of perceived opponents and dissidents in a brutal crackdown earlier this year. The same crown prince who detained princes, businessmen, clerics, academics, journalists, women's rights activists, even a poet? Today, Secretary of State Mike Pompeo was in Saudi Arabia to meet with the crown prince about the investigation into Khashoggi's death. Afterward, Pompeo said he, quote, emphasized the importance of conducting a thorough, transparent, and timely investigation, and the Saudi leadership pledged to deliver precisely on that. How much stock is anyone in the Trump administration putting in Saudi pledges? The Saudis originally claimed they had no idea what happened to Khashoggi. Now the Saudis are pledging to deliver a timely investigation. Timely, 2 weeks after Khashoggi disappeared. Timely. And in terms of how thorough and transparent it will be, Turkish officials say that their investigators discovered that rooms in the consulate, once they were allowed in there, rooms there had recently been repainted. Not to mention, of course, the cleaning crew that reporters saw entering the building yesterday before the investigators were let in. Are U.S. leaders really buying this? Or are they being played? Or are they part of a charade? Jeff Zeleny is out front at the White House tonight. Jeff, tell us more about President Trump likening the Saudi denials to Brett Kavanaugh.
Well, Jake, that is simply something that we have not heard him say before, but a bit of a word on the president's day. He had no public events on his schedule, so I'm told he was watching all the news coverage of this, was agitated throughout the day about how this news coverage was critical of him and critical of his administration not doing more. But then he decided spontaneously, I believe, to do more interviews. And it was in that Associated Press interview just a short time ago that he compared what was happening in Istanbul to Judge Kavanaugh, saying a guilty until proven innocent, making a play on that. Jake, that is discounting all history here. That is discounting everything that the Saudi kingdom has done and that U.S. intelligence knows they have done. The reality here is this. This White House, this president, his son-in-law, Jared Kushner, a senior advisor, they have wanted to forge this relationship with the Saudi crown prince. They have wanted to sell arms. They've wanted to do more. They certainly, you know, need the Saudi kingdom in their endeavors with Iran. But there was a sense here today that the White House is simply out of the picture. Republicans on Capitol Hill elsewhere saying more must be done. The U.S. must do more. Moral leadership simply, oblivious to the facts here. But the president still saying, now drawing this to a, you know, a domestic political argument, that simply does not square with the facts here, square with the reality of what we know. So we'll see what the president says tomorrow when he actually has events on his schedule, we believe, if he'll talk about this publicly. But boy, Jake, it's naive at best, likely much worse. Jake.
All right, Jeff Zeleny at the White House for us. And now more on the CNN studying new reporting that just broke. Sources telling CNN that a Saudi mission to interrogate and possibly abduct journalist Jamal Khashoggi in Istanbul was organized by a high-ranking officer in Saudi Arabia's main intelligence service, and that Khashoggi may have been injected with some kind of tranquilizer before he died in the consulate. Arwa Damon is in Istanbul for us. Arwa, what more are you learning about what the Saudis are claiming happened inside that consulate?
Well, again, this is all based on those three sources, Jake. But as you were saying there, according to one of them, Khashoggi may have been injected with a tranquilizer. That may have been what led to his death. And then there was this amateur effort to try to cover it up. Now, this senior officer is being described by a source as being close to the inner circle of the Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman, MBS, although it's unclear if MBS ordered an interrogation or an abduction at this stage. And you'll remember that CNN has previously reported that several U.S. officials have said that it is highly unlikely that such an operation would go ahead without the direct knowledge of the Crown Prince. Why was Khashoggi targeted? Well, according to one of these sources that CNN spoke to, it was because of the perception that he was very close to Saudi Arabia's arch enemy Qatar, although there has been absolutely no direct evidence of that. This officer is reported to have put his own team together, according to these sources, that he was not entirely transparent with Riyadh. He was not entirely forthcoming. And you'll remember that yesterday we were reporting that we are expecting a report to come out from Saudi Arabia, where the government, the kingdom, does actually acknowledge that this was an interrogation that had gone horribly, terribly wrong. That being said, it's also worth mentioning, Jake, that a Turkish official also told CNN that Khashoggi was cut up following his death. And while we were expecting the investigators and forensic teams to search the consul general's house tonight after waiting outside for hours once the road had been blocked off by police, no such investigation or search of those premises took place, Jake.
All right, Arwa Damon, thank you so much. Out front now is Maine's independent Senator Angus King, who caucuses with the Democrats. He sits on the Senate's Intelligence and Armed Services Committees. Senator, good to see you, as always. At this point, given all this reporting, do you believe the Saudi denials that the Crown Prince and the King knew about this? Are you prepared to believe that this was, as President Trump put it, rogue killers?
I don't believe the denials. Why would you believe the denials? Because they've had progressive denials. First, they said they knew nothing whatsoever. Had he left in good shape, they don't know what happened to him. Now, you know, they concede that he was there. Maybe he was killed. No, I just don't believe it. And that an operation of this sophistication with two jet airplanes coming in, 15 people. There was just a report in the New York Times moments ago that people that were seen getting off that airplane and going into the consulate were people who were closely identified with the Crown Prince, who traveled with him, who got off the plane with him in Paris or in America when he was over here on a goodwill mission about a year ago. So, no, I don't think the denials hold water. I mean, the evidence is building up. You know, obviously, we want to wait and see, but so far, the weight of the evidence looks like a pre-planned assassination. A guy arrives with a bone saw. Right. That doesn't sound like an interrogation plan to me.
Senator, President Trump just moments ago told the Associated Press that he thought this whole line of discussion that you and I are involved in right now is another example, as with Brett Kavanaugh, of guilty until proven innocent. And he has said multiple times that basically his administration believes the Saudis. Take a listen.
They deny it. They deny it every way you can imagine.
I just spoke with the King of Saudi Arabia, who denies any knowledge of what took place with regard to, as he said, his Saudi Arabian citizen. I've asked, and he firmly denied that. It sounded to me like maybe these could have been rogue killers.
And just tonight, he stressed again, he does not want to presume they're guilty until proven innocent, as he said. Do you think the president's being played, or is this all part of a charade in which the Saudis like need some sort of excuse because they got caught? How do you make sense of this?
Well, you could play that clip that you just played and put it beside a clip from last summer with President Putin of Russia, and it would sound almost exactly the same. He denied it. He told me firmly he denied it, and that seems to be enough. I kind of feel like it's back to Sergeant Schultz. Remember, I see nothing, I hear nothing, I know nothing, and it's sort of not wanting to know. The relationship with Saudi Arabia is complicated. It's important. They're a counterweight to Iran. I can understand the president's reluctance to wade in prematurely, but to basically bless the denials, it seems to me, doesn't advance the course of finding out what actually happened.